shall witness our power. Nay, nay, whether any spoon. They meet their match with Kino.
Mills.
Kino could have napped that one out.
Now you shall witness our power.
Pop on Spencer Honor!
Nene getting.
I admire your efforts, Nene.
Miss Tyrea seem like difficult sort of person to deal with.
Difficult, huh? Maybe so, but she's still far more mellow than before.
Miss Melia and Miss Tyrea know each other from where?
Well, it's a little complicated to explain.
Complicated how?
I'm just not quite sure where to begin. For one, Tyrea and I had never met until 1 year ago.
Houses too far apart, or...?
I was not allowed to venture outside. Moreover, I never even knew of her existence. She, on the other hand, seemed to know about me. We never met because work had been busy.
But how Miss Melia never know her? If sisters, then of course she'd know.
That's true. How can I explain this? Tyrea and I have separate parents. Different fathers and different mothers, both.
Meme! In same boat as Nene and Kino, then!
Just like you and Kino, Tyrea and I are not related by blood. But we had a half-brother with whom we shared a parent each.
Half-brother?
No parents in common. But a brother we are both related to. Therefore, Tyrea and I are not exactly complete strangers.
Meh! Brain of Nene's starting to melt!
I'm sorry. I did say it's complicated.
Nene does not understand. If both have same brother, why cannot be one family together?
Our parents being different, I and Tyrea have led very different lives. We never even met. Let alone behaved as a family. Neither knows how to relate to the other, and so we struggle on.
It sound like Miss Melia and Miss Tyrea both feeling more like Kino.
How do you mean?
Kino also not talk to anyone at first. Very hidey shy.
I don't think I'd call myself or Tyrea shy, exactly.
If want to become good friends, but not know how to put in action, then is exactly same. But as can see for self, now Nene and Kino super best of friends.
Do tell, how did you two achieve that? Would you teach me the way, please?
Answer is clear as day. Nene prescribed lots of play-play.
Play-play?
Also, sharing of yummy snacks and sleep together in same bed. If do that, become family in wink of eye.
I'm not sure I can do that with Tyrea. Seems like a lot.
Meh! Nene, patience is exhaust! Miss Melia want to be sisters with Miss Tyrea or not?
Yes. I would really like that, I think.
So, now is best and only chance. No time for hemmings and hawrings.
Best and only? Hmm? Perhaps you're right.
Okay, then now Miss Melia go and say, hey, Sister Bon, come play.
Right now? I need some time to compose myself.
Oh, if Miss Melia must, but have to promise to ask soon.
Yes, I will. One day very soon.
Thank you.
napped that one out.
Nene need more! More!
Boss!
shall witness our power.
They meet their match with Kino.
Nene, not like look of that one.
That's all.
Nene getting power.
I feel the ether. Building in me.
Shall witness our power.
Power dead upon certain remaining.
Witness true power of hero born in training.
Once Nene get back.
Greetings. We have heard from Teelan that a man called Radsom lives within these walls.
Ah, friends of Teelan's, are you? We've been expecting you. Go on, in you get.
You're letting us straight through.
You don't look particularly concerning, is all. These walls are imposing, but they aren't here for controlling foot traffic. They're to keep savage monsters from having themselves a rampage.
Most sensible. Well, we'll be going then.
Vikings! Sorry for time taking.
just want nap.
Splendid Omu! Oh, it's true! Scales so shiny and sparkly!
It looks the same as any Amu, if you ask me.
Different subtle.
Sure is.
Really?
Pardon me. Have you come from Companion's Cape, by any chance?
We've just come from the laboratory. But we were at the Cape just before that.
And was everyone there all right?
Yes, it seemed to me.
Thank goodness. That's a relief to hear.
Is something wrong?
You may be aware, but originally, we all lived here together as a group.
But then, some left because there are Machina here.
Exactly. At first, we managed to tolerate each other in relative harmony. Obviously, we had our share of friction.
What happened?
Well, the final straw was something trivial. The Companions tried all sorts of ploys to retake the capital, but none of the plans succeeded. Many soldiers were lost this way. One Machina had had enough and told them to just give up.
And that's when it happened?
Yeah. They shouted, "If you rust rats hadn't betrayed us, we wouldn't have lost our brethren and our homes in the first place." Things got heated, and then they left and didn't look back.
They shouldn't have forgotten that we all lost friends, family, and homes.
They're soldiers, ma'am. In the war, they put everything on the line for their country. And so,
when their country was taken from them, the extent of their anger and resentment was fully understandable.
Yes. Still, we who stayed behind don't bear them any grudges. They protected us all, for a long time, regardless of race. And bear in mind, in the end, they didn't cast the Machina out. They left the safety of our walls of their own volition. That's why we pledged that if they chose to return, we'd welcome them back and meet them with a smile.
I will do whatever is in my power to make it so.
Nay, white eyes sweating. Inflammation of tear ducts.
By the way, we have heard that someone by the name of Radzim lives here.
Radzim? Yes, he lives over there.
Over there. Thank you. Very kind.
It was Radzim, actually. He was the one who told the Companions to give up their quest.
Right. I see.
All right. Let's go and see him straight away.
Yes, let's.
Yes?
Psst.
Hello.
Are you perchance Radsom?
Yeah, that's me. How do you know my name?
Teelan mentioned you. You are his fellow researcher.
Oh, I see. Teelan sent you. Him and Tyrae are still getting on, okay?
Quite. Though she did give him a good scolding earlier.
Went to Alchemoth again, did he? I did warn him not to be reckless. But when it comes to his research, that boy has tunnel vision. To be honest, so does Tyrea.
Does she come here much as well?
No, hardly ever. She's even more focused on the work than Teelan. I couldn't begin to guess why she's so driven.
It must be about her mother after all.
Radsom, we have questions. About the Fog King.
I see. That's why you're so curious.
We need more to go on. What can you tell us?
Because of the Telethia's ether field, the Fog King and his Fog Beasts seem, well, unable to escape Alchemoth.
Ether field?
Yeah. It's the means by which Telethia eliminate any excess ether that they absorb. Now, the Fog King and his beasts happen to give off an awful lot of ether.
I see. So all Telethia in the vicinity flock there, to feed on the ether. And, as a result, keep the threat contained.
Oh, this hot noggin of Kino. It get worse if not shut up.
But my ether, it worked against Fog Beasts, but not the Fog King. Or rather, it didn't even seem to make direct contact with him.
Shulk, Melia, would you do me a favor and head to Teelan's lab, borrow his Telethia research notes for me?
Sure, we can do that for you.
There's something I'd like to look up about the Telethia's ether field.
Understood.
On another note, we heard that you spoke out against the Companions.
I voiced an opinion, yes. I can understand their impatience. Their ancestral home was right there. However, I couldn't abide watching them throw away more lives for nothing.
Nothing. Sounds quite stark.
At first, there were hundreds of us living here. But now? Well, you've seen for yourselves.
And all because of the Fog King.
Yeah. So I think you can see why I said what I said. If we end up extinct, we'll have won nothing.
Well spoken. But I'm sure the companions would find those words hard to swallow. I'm sorry. Your people are no more free to go home than we are.
No need for you to apologize, Melia. In truth, it's not costing me any sleep. They seem to be catching on too. After all, they've stayed put since then.
When you put it like that, the people of Grandel, they're living under considerable strain, not knowing what became of their homes, and with no means of return.
Hmm. But that's also true of Maxis. His people lost their homes too.
Yes. But they're feeling desperate, and it's making them unreasonable.
It too sad.
We were like that too once, weren't we?
Yes, we were.
That true?
Hmm. But we learned, eventually. All because we wanted to protect the world. And we made that dream a reality. We brought down Zanza.
Overcoming our prejudice gave us strength in unity. Because we shared a goal.
Radzum's folk, the companions, and us as well. We all share the same goal.
Defeating the Fog King and returning home.
Hmm.
Sounds like job for Hero Punkino.
Just let Nene at him.
Thank you, everyone.
Mamma meh, what that thing?
Is that?
It's like the one we saw in Alchemoth, but much, much larger.
You're right.
Shulk, let's see if we can get closer.
Yeah.
I approach my limit.
Please to hang in there.
All right.
What is happening over there? fog.
Huh? Fog beasts?
Here they come!
No time for deliberations. Let's go, Shulk.
Got it! Fog beasts were meant to be confined within Alkemoth. I don't think that's where those ones came from.
What do you mean?
The rift made normal monsters transform into fog beasts.
Grandel!
Ah!
What is matter?
The Armus could turn into fog beasts.
Meh, meh! No one to picture that! Must hurry to rescue!
Thank you.
Your instinct was right, Melia.
Yes, although the rift's influence is spreading far too quickly.
Radson, are you fine?
Miss Melia, these are moves. It was so sudden.
You can explain later. Let us do the fighting here. You should seek refuge.
Right you are.
Stop those armies.
Yeah.
Bad army. Go to bed without dindins.
Kino, show off launching skills.
Your fear split edge!
Hammer
beam! Let's keep under pressure! We can definitely do this! Minato, lend us your power! Yeah. How's this?
Thank you for that.
Was everyone all right?
Yeah. No major injuries to speak of. All thanks to you, of course.
Kino accepts your supply of sweet wasabi as reward.
Real Hereupon never has compensation.
Where it say that?
Shulk, was it the Rift's expanding influence that's responsible for our Armu's transformation?
Looks like it. We saw it happen before, too. Regular monsters turned into fog beasts, just like that.
That suggests more fog beasts will appear if the Rift continues to spread its vileness. Consider, with the size it was before, the Rift's effect was limited to the area within the capital. But now it's getting wider.
One moment. In that case, if the Rift keeps growing larger...
all monsters everywhere could be changed by the fog.
We must find a way to fight back.
We'll need those research notes for that. Let's head for the lab.
Right.
Villain! What do you want?
You stand in the way of a new age dawning.
Sis, I'm scared.
It's all right. I'll protect you, and I'll work, I swear.
Behold, the widening rift in the sky. It's proof definite the world abhors you.
Spare me your ravings.
Oh, Lady Melia, the hope of our race.
Gelgar, what is this treachery?
As you can see, I am sweeping away some pebbles. Their research is blasphemy against the commingled blood.
Don't you comprehend the import of what you're interrupting? The very future of our race hinges on their work.
You think this is the future? This reactionary struggle to revive what is long buried? The future of the Hyentia is us. We are what the race ought to become. We are the true face of the Hyentia.
If not for our ancestors, we would never even have drawn breath.
Ancestors? I recognize them not. You, Lady Melia, are our progenitor. You were our beginning, and you will be our future.
Senseless drivel. If you would interfere with this research for the sake of spouting your nonsense, you do not deserve my mercy!
Melia!
Why won't you understand? Why won't you accept that we are the ones destined to lead?
You will not so easily refute our history.
So be it. I reject you. I will take the mantle and become father of our kin. I will take dominion over all, and the world will be set to rights.
Dream it!
All right, I'm feeling it.
Yeah!
Or know your place. I know I am not wrong. I'm not.
I will spare you. Just be gone from my sight.
No! The lab!
Melia!
Miss Melia!
No! Idiots!
The crown is mine now.
Talon!
Vixis, help!
Better safe than sorry. The pure blood meets its end today.
Are you okay, Talon?
Talethia, here! Damn!
She's okay. She's all right.
I'm sorry. I couldn't save. The future.
Melia!
Miss Melia!
Kino, you did it!
Applause.
Where?
We're in Radzim's house. The lab went up in flames, so we carried you here.
The lab? I'm sorry, Teelan. I failed you.
Miss Malia.
You damn fool! What possessed you to do that? What happened to safeguarding the future of the Hyentia? And bringing our brethren back home, were those just words to you? You should think long and hard about what the death of a leader would mean for us!
Come on, Big Sis, that's enough!
Don't defend her, this idiot child.
I had to.
What?
To protect it at all cost. The research.
How can you be so fixated on that?
Our salvation lies therein. I believe it now.
Melia!
And yet, ultimately it was for naught. I caused trouble for everyone. And I couldn't even save the documents.
Poor Miss Melly.
That's not true. If you and your friends hadn't come when you did, there might not have been anything left of the research to continue with. And also, here.
What's this?
It's the book you carried out of the fire. Ring any bells?
This tome. We found it in the tomb.
Yeah. The book that started my research. If we have this, me and Tyrea can carry on with our work. Sis, are you with me?
Yes, right. We can study the problem until we make some headway.
Miss Melia, thank you.
Likewise.
Teelan. Tyrea.
You've only just woken up. Come on, we'll let you rest.
Yes, thank you.
What that for?
Kino used Tranquil Snooze for sea sweet dreams. That seemed extremely excessive.
This might just be what we need to defeat the Fog King.
Yeah.
Feeling better?
Yes. Much better now.
What a relief!
Miss Melly, good as new. Kino saved day again. Less braggy, please.
Friends, I'm sorry I worried you. And I abused your hospitality. Please forgive me.
No. You saved this place and we owe you, big time. This was the least I could do.
I will not stop now. I swear to do what I can for the good of Grandel.
I appreciate it. Just don't go running yourself ragged for us.
I promise. We seem to be missing Tyrea.
Oh, if you're looking for her, she figured the fog beasts might strike again, so she went out on patrol.
The likes of us aren't exactly trained for battle. So, really, any help is welcome.
You're right. I feel sorry for any beasts that wander into Tyrea's path. By the way, did I hear you mention something about defeating the Fog King?
All thanks to our friend's research.
Is that so?
Quite.
A sterling achievement, Teelan.
Just an accident.
Still, even so, your devotion to your mother may well have saved our future. All right. What do we have to do? How do we defeat the Fog King?
We found ether attacks effective against fog beasts, but not against the Fog King. That's because the ether's concentration was too low.
Concentration?
Concentration? Pipe down when adults talking, dum-dum.
But Kino's so bored!
The whole thing got me wondering. Why did fog beasts appear when the rift got wider? I think the intensity of the rift's rays exceeded the density of the Telethia's ether field.
None of that makes any sense to me. How is the density connected to the Fog King?
If we could put up an ether field denser than the Telethia's, the Fog King will become vulnerable.
How does one put up an ether field? Secondly, where does one obtain such highly concentrated ether?
For the field, I think this guy will do the job, with a little tinkering.
In that case, it's just a matter of gathering up enough high-purity ether crystals, except...
Except what?
Those kinds of ether crystals are extremely rare. I'm not sure where I'd even start looking. There might be none at all around here.
Oh, cheer up, all of you. It is not a foregone conclusion. And in any scenario, if we cannot defeat the Fog King without them, we will have to keep looking until we find them.
True enough.
Good. Then let us start by asking around.
Hey!
A-okay.
Hey! Ha ha!
Cut!
Thank you.
What's up?
Warming up, Nene!
help of sorts.
Shadow
One!
Healing
Bullets!
Shy
help me!
Kino, that would be... Behold the power of the Monado!
Very
good,
brother.
Nothing to it! Nene!
Such a maze!
But no stealing of limelight!
Yeah, nice going!
It's good,
Very good. Roll! Crazy thing! Good job, everyone!
Nene needs more! More!
Never give up, Spirit is here upon way!
Right! Let's do this!
Power of dead upon Sir through Nene! Witness true power of hero born in training! That's nice, Mr. Show!
Like salty diamonds!
Nene need more! More!
To Nanona? Brave mortal!
Everyone, let's go!
Silly faces going down!
Paradenopon search for Nanian!
Shadow Eye!
Could have knocked that one out.
Let's go!
Witness true power of Hero Pon in training!
Nene, weather any storm!
I'm really feeling it! Everyone,
Pollen Mill. Kino plus psychics are non-defeatable!
Mr. Shulk stopped so sudden.
I was just thinking about the cave near Colony 9. Do you know it, Nene? It's called Tefra Cave.
Nene, no place. Nene tag along once with group of Hum Hum. Went to fetch ether cylinders.
I've done that too sometimes. Went with Ryan a couple of times.
Mama, hooray for twinsies! Nene went there during rebuilding effort.
So you did your part to help Nene. Thanks for that.
It not thing that need thanks per se. Just doing civic duty. Must stay friends and work together. With all peoples that live in world.
That's right.
But folk here have lot of angry kerscuffles. Fight between neighbors bad. Should watch Nene and Kino. Learn to everyone play nice.
Well, I wouldn't say the people here are enemies exactly. They just don't know how to work out their feelings.
That just fancy way of saying fighting?
It's not exactly like fighting. Both sides do understand each other, but their paths took them in different directions.
What Mr. Shock mean?
If the two sides had simply hated each other, they wouldn't just leave. They'd try to drive the other side out by force. But that's not what they did. They still have common ground to stand on. And Melly is here now. They just need some time to mull things over.
Mr. Shulk is very kind person. Very different from Mama Pon. When Nene and Kino get into bad fight, Mama Pon spank first, then ask questions. Nene and Kino always in tears, but always say sorries and make up with hug-hug. End of end, friendship become much stronger. Being friends mean a whole lot more fun, and more fun is more good. Also, everyone in Colony 9 was friends from start of start.
Well, that's because everyone there was working to help rebuild. We all share the same dream.
But dreams of people here all really all that different from each other.
For now, I guess. But Melly is doing the best she can, and we need to as well.
Nene understand. Nene will wait until Miss Melia make dreams of everyone mush together as one. But if dream of Miss Melia not go through to everyone, in that case, Nene will give vicious spankings and no one spared, even not Mr. Shulk.
What? Me as well? Just promise to be gentle.
Yeah! one for me!
Really feeling it.
Whoa!
Nene get back? Winning just come natural to Kino.
Big sis.
Winning just come natural to Kino.
Are you that?
So now all we need to do is modify the weapon to incorporate the crystals.
Radzim, sir! Fog beasts have broken through the gates!
They're through!
If only they'd waited a few hours. Shulk, defending Grandel is our priority. Follow me.
Right.
We shall deal with the intruders. You get the villagers to safety.
Okay.
Teelan, you stay put.
Gotcha!
We're here to help.
This rabble won't stand a chance. Not against the big one. We'll keep the small fry off your back.
All right. You go no further.
Yeah.
Fleet light is no use. Kino make you full of holes.
And Nene teach you better manners.
We beat them this time, but the numbers are against us. I hate to say it, but if you'd already left when the attack happened, we'd be smoke.
Fog King must go! Down with Fog King!
Situation is tough.
I agree.
Melia?
I'll do it. I will bring the companions back to lend you aid.
They won't agree. You know they despise us.
They must see the danger. They will understand what needs to be done. Yea. As soldiers of the High Entia, they know it's their solemn duty. I swear it. I will bring them back with me. Please. Trust me, Radsom.
I'll be right here, trusting and waiting.
Tyrea.
Yeah, yeah. Hurry up and go.
But I haven't even...
Defend this place until I return. Those are your orders, right? Though we're short-handed as it is.
Will you be okay?
Just go before I change my mind.
Thank you. We'll be quick.
Movement! Multiple biggins confirmed!
Impossible! More already! If the rift grows any wider than it is now, Grandel is lost. We must hurry. Come, follow me.
You head straight for the Cape.
What are you saying? This will take all of us.
I know exactly what my orders are here. I hope I don't have to remind you what yours are.
But that's...
You said it yourself. If the rift grows any wider, there's no way we'll be able to hold this place alone anyway. This is our last chance to enlist the Companion's aid.
Tyrea.
Radsom is trusting you with this. Now you put your trust in me.
Come on, we make for the Companion's Cape.
All of them. We're in the clear.
Breathe deep, men, and prepare for the next wave. Let's go through this again. Hyentia, deploy your shields. Stop the advance on the gates. Anyone with a rifle,
Clean out small targets in range. Remember, all we're here to do is buy time. Eliminating all threats is not our mission. Make no mistake.
Mom!
Fog be sighted!
To arms!
They're all just gone.
What? But how?
How are you? All well?
Yeah.
What the hell are you?
Never you mind that. We've come to make a request. Time is of the essence.
Go on.
Would you return to Grandel?
If you're asking like that, I assume you know why we left.
Indeed.
Then you must know why that's not an option.
What if I said Grandel is besieged by fog beasts?
Are you serious?
I'm far too busy to come here just to lie.
And the villagers? Are they safe?
Yes, for the time being. But not for much longer. You don't seem all that surprised, Maxis.
No, I didn't know. Just connecting the dots. If we were hit, then...
Well, I trust I needn't spell it out for you. A veteran of the Guard.
You need not. But it's not as simple as you make it out.
I never said anything about simple.
But you did ask.
You forget yourself, Maxis.
Do I now?
What matters here is that the lives you have been guarding are once again in danger as we speak.
Yes, but...
You're free to have your reasons. But you need to find a way to accept reality and move forward in your life. Maxis, we are the lucky ones.
What do you mean?
We can go home.
That's nonsense. The Fog King has Alchemoth.
Yes, but our home is right there, even if we cannot live in it now. But what of the other refugees? To them, home is gone. Even if they could leave, they have no certainty home still exists.
But we... left them for dead. How can we possibly...
It is never too late to make amends. As long as you live. After all, despite your quarrels, you are neighbors, family. Those bonds can withstand more than you think. Maxis, realize what you have. Do it before it's too late. Or you'll regret it.
Maxis, I'm going with these people. I can't turn my back on them.
Maxis?
You're damn good. All right, I'm in.
So you're with us?
Truly?
Yes, but it wasn't your fancy words that swayed me. My family needs me.
Fine. As you wish.
Birdman painting Bom Bom.
Real feather brain.
Thank you.
Winning just come natural to Keynotes.
Scratch.
Don't drop your guard!
Well, Kino, more than enough for this.
We'll be standing on the safer plank.
Yeah! Hammer! Yeah!
The power of the
Monado!
Oh,
any faster than you!
Nene! Whoa! That was close!
What? That was almost like a picnic shot!
Good, good! It's good! Nene,
ready and able!
Oh.
Be
proud! All right! I'm feeling it! I'm really feeling it!
That's
enough,
Mr. Shelf!
Nene
getting
fast! We can definitely do this! This is the Monado's power! Yeah! Inspectors, we're ready for your assistance! We got through that pretty good!
Kino could have knocked that one out!
Nene need more!
Greetings.
Battle with them, Mark. Cigarette!
Point upper!
Nene's starting to get toasty.
Oh, good to win! I'm really feeling it. That was too easy.
Kino plus psychics are non-defeatable. Did Nene not
win? We can't lose.
They meet their match with Kino. Nene, take you on myself.
I'm really feeling it.
Nice moves, Mr. Schultz. Nene, ready to
go. Behold the power of the Monado. Set it!
Thank you.
Useless little spoiled princess brat!
No sign of Miss Mayor yet?
Not so far! Damn! Bunch of new hostiles closing in!
I guess the lot from the Cape really left us for dead. Miss Tarea, it's all over. Please pull back!
Not just yet! Stand firm! Believe in our brethren! Believe! In your new leader!
But Matt! There's only so much you can do!
When you see me fall, abandon this place and withdraw into Grand Dell.
Victoria!
He kept us waiting. You big jerk!
Lady Melia!
She's back! And it looks like you brought the companions with her!
Let's clear a path!
Everyone!
Maxis, thank you.
Ha! It's me who should be thanking you, Ransom. If you hadn't spoken out when you did, we couldn't be having this conversation.
What are you talking about? If it weren't for your help, we'd all have kicked it ages ago.
Miss Melly looking for Tyrea? She go back after healing.
Cannot put up with this sentimental manure. Was exact words.
Sounds just like her.
To a T.
Lady Melia, I'm glad we trusted you. We owe you a debt for our lives.
No, you have only each other to thank.
Huh? Wait up. Melia? Did he say Melia?
Indeed.
Surely not. You can't be the Melia Antiqua.
Antiqua?
Yes. I do get called that sometimes.
No. What? That means your Highness is the Crown Princess Melia.
Do you need a minute, Maxis?
Impudence. This girl is the true-born child of our late Emperor Sorin, the Imperial successor, Crown Princess Melia Antiqua.
Is he telling the truth?
It was not my intent to deceive. I thought if I announced myself, it could bring hope, but it could also bring despair. What our people need now is hope only. Hence the discretion. I'd appreciate if you treated me normally. Right. That is enough of that. Much work remains, after all.
You mean slaying the Fog King? Lady Melia, we companions will form your honor guard.
You won't. You companions will join Tyrea and guard Brandel from Fogbeast Incursion.
But that's...
Listen to me, Maxis. You feel you want to dispel the regrets of your brethren by your own hands. I understand well. But for the sake of those fallen, you must protect the living. Don't you think that's the best way to use your talents right now? The Companion's strength, Grandel's knowledge, Tyrea's will. Without any one of those, the town would be lost. It's the only way.
I understand. We accept. Trust us with the ramparts.
Thank you. Truly.
Lady Melia, take care.
Absolutely.
Maxis and his companions, they're counting on us, too.
Yes. Let us perform the enhancements at Radsim's. May we, Radsim?
Only too gladly, Miss Melia.
It's ready.
Ha! Huh? It's not changed much.
Still same.
Quite.
Well, it was more of a tweak.
I don't mind. If it lets us take down the Fog King.
Theoretically.
Finally come time for denouement. Days of Fog King numbered!
Well, it is time.
Please come back safe.
But to prepare a feast while wait.
T'Lan, not to cause mischief in meantime, okay?
So, you did it.
Thanks to you, and to T'Lan.
Strength and honor, friend.
We will do our best.
The Fog King is in the villa.
You saw it?
Yeah.
But how will we get in there? I tried to enter several times, but the transporter refused to work.
That's because it was set so that only I could activate it.
Why?
The villa was where I rescued Teelan from the Fog King's clutches before you came. I wanted to seal it off and trap the monster inside.
Except...
the transporters, they don't mean a damn thing to it. Still, it seemed better than nothing, so I put it on lockdown.
Is that...
I used this for authentication. Take it. I have no need of it anymore.
I see.
We'll keep guard here, don't worry.
Good. I shall count on it.
Our race's future is in your hands. Got it?
All right. I won't let you down. Well, let's go.
Nene got friends and friends of friends.
That line of Hero Porcino!
You brave few who venture forth, we salute you!